working on the YouTube? How about on the Facebook? Anybody there yet? Anybody there? Can you see me? Can you hear me? Can you see me? Can you hear me? Larry, all right? Can you see me and hear me? I guess the answer is yes. That is good. That is good. All right, what's going on? Minneapolis in the house. Yeah, tell me where you're at. Tell me where you're tuning in from. Let me see what's going on. Just want to make sure everything's working. Paul, thank you. Jody, all right. Yes, yes, yes. Kevin, good to see you guys. It's been, I wrote it down, the last one of these I did was June 25th. So it has been a while. It has been a while, my friends. So, yeah, just want to kind of check out, make sure the audio's working.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, it is. All right. Who else is in the house here? Brian, what's going on, man? What is going on, my friends? All right. It looks like we're working. It looks like things are working here. Yeah. How's Arizona doing? Germany in the house. Lancaster. Yeah, it's a little warm here in Southern California. Not too bad. Not too bad. Got a little bit of a new thing I'm going to do for you guys today. A little different of a show. I've been not doing this for a while, and I wanted to kind of show you guys some stuff. I'm going to get warmed up a little bit, just because I'm a little rusty. Haven't been doing as much performing. So I'm going to warm up. It's Freddie King's birthday today, if he was still alive. I'm not sure how old he would be, but he passed away quite a while back. It is his birthday today. He passed away at the age of 42. I already kind of set up a little loop. I'm just going to kind of warm up a little bit, and I'm going to play along to kind of one of his probably better known tunes. I just kind of made a little loop earlier before I came on. This is Going Down by Freddie King. I'm just going to warm up, wiggle my fingers a little bit, see how things are going in. Italy in the house. Reverend Bill watching on the YouTube. All right, let me get warmed up. Then I'm gonna break down some riffs. I'm gonna talk about my new record called The New World Blues, which is coming out October 23rd on Whiskey Bayou Records. We're gonna break down one of the riffs on that record. We're gonna do a little name that song. Larry is one of the reigning champions. Larry and Colleen are, I think, tied at this point. We're gonna do some name that songs. We're going to do another guitar pick of the week. And for you foodies, I might even give you a little recipe advice if you're down with that. So we got Italy in the house, Argentina, Rosario. I've been to Rosario, Argentina many years ago. Phoenix. All right, you guys, I'm going to jam out a little bit, and then we'll get into a riff and a song off of my new record. Thank you. Warming up a little. That's, believe me, that's rusty. But I appreciate the kind words. Pam in the house. Kashi in the house. What's going on? Corey in the house. You guys, thanks for tuning in. I got a lot of stuff I want to try and get done today and talk to you guys about. And see if I remember how to do this whole live broadcast thing. The live broadcast thing. Hopefully I won't mess it up. If everything goes out and it all ends, I'll try and get hop back on as soon as possible. So, yes, you can see scrolling at the bottom. We are going to be talking about my record that's going to be coming up here very shortly. It is called The New World Blues. And there is the cover, ladies and gentlemen. It was produced by Tab Benoit. It's coming out on Whiskey Bayou Records on October 23rd. That's pretty much what I'm going to be talking about for the next couple months, is promoting this. No shows to speak of, really. We're working on some streaming stuff to show you guys at a certain point, to be announced. But we're going to be promoting on social media and all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to need your guys' help with this to kind of spread the word out there and get this CD out there into the world and heard. So right now I'm just going to show you guys, if you want to pre-order, I'm going to give you a little bit of information right here. Right now you can pre-order this record, which is an important part of the process for us, is the pre-order, because those all kind of count towards the first week of sales, and that's kind of a big deal. That kind of helps get on some charts, get on some radio people's radars and whatnot. So if you go to whiskeybayourecords.com, you can pre-order, and they will ship to anywhere in the world. If you're in the United States and you'd like to pre-order a signed copy from me, you can go to my website and I'll send you one. And the cost is almost identical either way, but shipping to Europe is obviously more expensive. So check it out. Want to talk a little bit about the artwork here. I've had some people kind of chime in about this, and I'm really excited about the artwork. The artwork was done for the cover art was done by my friend Sean McHugh, and if you've been paying attention to my last few records, you know he's been a huge part of my last few records. He was the engineer on Trouble at Your Door and Dream Train, and he was also the engineer and mixed and mastered Live from the 805. He designed the cover art for Dream Train, Live from the 805, and this record here too. And he also took that photo. We were thinking of things that we wanted to do for the cover art. And we took some photos, and this one kind of spoke to us. And there you go. That's the cover of the new record. It's black and white. The whole thing is black and white. And I like it. I dig it. And I hope you guys like it. So I'm going to get back to some of that. We'll talk some more about that momentarily. And while we're on this topic of showing you guys some stuff, some links, I'll throw some tip jar stuff up, but I don't want you guys to feel obligated for that. You know, if you want to pre-order the record, that'd be awesome. We'd really appreciate that. And if you are looking for a worthy cause of the week, which I do every time I do one of these, we are doing, once again, we're going back to the Blues Musician Emergency Relief Fund. That's sponsored by and organized by the Blues Foundation, blues.org. You can check that out. That is a very worthy cause. Very, very worthy cause. So that's my worthy cause of the week. Let's get into a riff here. I want to show you a riff from a song called Lies and Fear, which is the second track on the New World Blues. But I want to show you kind of how I came up with it. Let me read the comments real quick. Chris, what's going on? Larry, I know you got one. Cynthia, how are you? Joe, what's up? Pam in the house. Daryl. All right, Daryl may not make it. Well, tell Daryl I said hi. I messaged him earlier today. So I'm going to show you this riff, but before I show you my riff, I want to show you how I came to my riff. And I think it might be interesting for you guys to hear kind of how riffs evolve over time and how people kind of get influenced by things. So if you can hopefully hear this, let me know if you can hear this. I want to start with a riff by a guy named Luther Snakeboy Johnson. And I didn't really discover him until fairly recently. I was down on the old YouTube rabbit hole, and I found the song called Woman Don't Lie. And it turns out it's been covered by a couple friends of mine. Albert Castilla has covered it on one of his records, and Walter Trout covered it on one of his records. I didn't know that at the time when I heard this song. So I'm going to play you this riff. I'm going to kind of show you what is involved with this. And I'll show you how this kind of evolved into the song called Lies and Fears on my record. So here's a little Luther Snakeboy Johnson. I'll show you how this goes. Can you guys hear that a little bit on there? Okay, so that's his riff. Killer, just three notes, syncopated and funky. And I've always really liked these style riffs because you can pick up a guitar and you can figure out how to play it fairly easily. And I love those kinds of riffs where you can figure it out and it just grooves. And so this is in the key of B. And it goes through all the changes with that riff. So that's the Luther Snakeboy Johnson riff. And so I love that riff. And here's another kind of similar one that I believe is later. This is from a band called Rare Earth, which I didn't get really turned on to until probably late 90s. And if you're of that age where you were listening to funky music in the 70s, you might recognize this song. This has got a great riff, and all these riffs are related and similar, and hopefully you'll hear the similarity. This is a song called I Just Want to Celebrate. So check this out real quick. So real similar, we're in the key of D for this one. Back to the Luther Snakeboy Johnson riff. All right, and then I Just Want to Celebrate. So two great riffs, and then this next one I'm going to play you is probably where I got the idea for my riff, although I was already influenced by the two previous. This is a Gary Moore song off of a record called Bad For You Baby. This song's called Umbrella Man, and this is in the key of A. So we're kind of moving around keys right now, but you can hear the similarity in all these riffs. So here's the Gary Moore riff right here. All right, so there's the Gary Moore riff. So you can hear how all these riffs kind of have similar aspects to them. And it's just three and maybe four notes. So my riff, which is, I would like to think, derivative of all those, but is really very derivative of the Gary Moore riff, is from a song called Lies and Fear. And it's in the key of G. So I'm different key. Once again, Woman Don't Lie is in B. I Just Want to Celebrate is in D. Umbrella Man is in A. And my riff that I wrote for Lies and Fear is in the key of G. Evolved, like I said, song two on the New World Blues. And I hope you guys love the record as much as I love making it. We had a great time making it. So we're gonna kind of move through a couple things here. And I'm going to talk to you real quick about some riffs. Now, once again, we're going to do we're going to kind of combine some stuff from previous Throwdown Thursdays. I'm going to do a few of these right here in a row, and I'll explain why. Some of it will be obvious. Some of it won't be obvious. So I'm going to do some Name That riffs right now. So if you guys have your hands on the keyboard, if you don't remember the rules to Name That riff, I'll tell you right now. So I need the artist or band name and the song in one comment. You can't go Led Zeppelin, you know, rock and roll in two different comments, or Zepp, or just the song, or just the artist. I need the artist and the song in one comment. And typically the first thing that I see is the one that ends up being the winner. So I know sometimes when you press send, you think that you're the first comment, but whatever it is that shows up on my computer is typically the one that wins. So you guys ready? We're going to do a few of these in a row. Want to kind of get into some of these. It's been fun learning and reconnecting with some of these riffs. I'm going to kind of pick riffs from some different genres. And I'll start this one. I'll just start playing and see who gets it. So you guys ready? You guys ready for Name That riff? All right, here we go. All right. You guys all got your hands on your keyboards. You guys ready for this? Name That riff time. All right, here we go. Dennis got it. You're a close ball. Yep, Dennis got it, and the full guess there, Dennis McKee. Victor, you were close. You had the song, and then you had the artist. But like I said, I need them both in the same comment. Paul, you were close. Paul, you got in there with the right song, wrong artist. Victor, you got in there with the right song, no artist. And it looks like Dennis was the first one to get in there with the artist and the song. That is riff number one. Winner goes to Dennis McKee right there. And so you get bragging rights for until the next time we do one of these. So right on, right on, right on. All right, next riff. Now, I wanted to talk about, I did the Freddie King, obviously, because it's Freddie King's birthday today. And while we're doing that, I wanted to share a little bit of vinyl. I don't have a ton of Freddie King on vinyl, but this is an amazing record, if you can see that. It's called Getting Ready. This is the record that has Going Down on it. And it's fantastic. Leon Russell plays piano and some guitar on it. Duck Dunn plays bass on it. It's a fantastic record produced by Leon Russell and Don Nix. Same Old Blues, Dust My Broom, Worried Life Blues, Five Long Years, Key to the Highway. A lot of covers there. Going Down, famous song right there. Living on the Highway, which is a great Leon Russell, Don Nix song. Walking by Myself, Old Blues Standard. Tore Down, Freddie King. Tore Down, I think it might have been re-recorded for this record, and Palace of the King, which is a great record. So this is one of my vinyl picks right here. Freddie King, Getting Ready. A great, 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 great record. All right, so who's ready? Video isn't playing. Nancy McKenzie, video isn't playing. You guys frozen? How's it look, everybody? Can you hear it? Can you see it? Are we loud and clear? I hope so. I can double check right here. Great record. Looks like it's happening. Hey, Rich, what's going on? All right. Well, here we go. This is the second one. And I'll tell you why I'm playing this one. I got to kind of turn up the distortion a little bit on this one. So again, for Name That Riff, I need the band and the song in the same comment. Okay, so if it's Eric Clapton and the song is whatever, Lay Down Sally, it needs to say that in one thing. All right, here we go. This is Name That Riff number 2. Is that band and song? Anybody? Bueller. I've heard it, but I'm blank. Where are you at? Who's got the answer? Larry gets it. 2 minutes to midnight from Iron Maiden. Larry, I had a feeling you were going to get that one. Great riff, great record. And so let's talk about it. Why am I playing Iron Maiden today? Because this record, my favorite Iron Maiden record, came out on this day in 1984. Power Slave, Egyptian theme, slave to the power of death, as the Bruce Dickinson wrote for the title track. It's about an Egyptian pharaoh. Anyhow, one of the look at the artwork is great. Derek Riggs, probably my favorite Iron Maiden record. One of my top records of all time. This was a hugely influential record for me as a kid. I was 13 when this came out in 1984, so you can imagine the impression it made. 8 songs, all of which are fantastic. Ace is High, 2 Minutes to Midnight that I just played. Lost for Words, which is an instrumental. Great name for an instrumental, Lost for Words. Get it? Flash of the Blade, The Duelists, Back in the Village, Power Slave, Rime of the Ancient Mariner, playing time 51 minutes 20 seconds, produced by the late great Martin Birch, who passed away recently, produced, engineered, and mixed by Martin Birch, Bruce Dickinson, Steve Harris, Adrian Smith, Dave Murray, and Nico McBrain. This is a masterpiece here. So they get, you know, they recorded this as a live album on this tour called Live After Death. And I was at one of the shows that they recorded at the Long Beach Arena. Scream for Me, Long Beach is a very famous term if you're a Maiden fan. So I was there for that. And because they did Rime of the Ancient Mariner, you know, they wrote a lot of songs about a lot of different things. And when I was in high school English class, we were studying the poem by Samuel Taylor Coleridge called The Rime of the Ancient Mariner. And I convinced my high school English teacher, Mrs. Lepsky, I believe her name was. See, I'm drawing a blank there. I convinced her to let me bring in the videotape of the live version of the song with the lyrics printed out for the whole class. And I got to get the class to watch the entire Rime of the Ancient Mariner video. Anyhow, great one. I'm going to do one more, you guys. I'm having a good time. How are you guys doing? Let me check in. Breaking the Law is a good riff. I would have to, I think I remember how to play Breaking the Law. What is it? That's it, right? Breaking the Law? That's another great lit riff right there. Live After Death. I know, Maiden is such a great band. All right, you guys. You right. Great out. I'm going to do one more of these, you guys. Before I do this, I want to get back to one of these things that I'm talking about I already kind of told you about the pre-order. I'd like to kind of just discuss something with you guys real quick while we're here, while we're all here kind of talking about stuff. So Facebook, it looks like they're instituting some new rules about live streams and stuff. So there's a little bit of a question as to whether or not you can actually play other people's material, if they're going to allow streaming and stuff. So I'm trying to keep these versions of these songs short that aren't mine. So I also want to mention that because of that, you know, I am also simulcasting on my YouTube channel. Now, I don't know how many of you guys have YouTube accounts, but if you do have a YouTube account, you can do me a solid and go to YouTube and subscribe to my channel. Believe it or not, if you go there right now, Larry, you're going to appreciate this. I have 666 subscribers right now. And I believe starting in October, you need to have 1,000 subscribers on your YouTube channel in order to broadcast live feeds. That's just what I've heard. I've read a little bit. There's a lot of kind of new information coming out. So if you guys have a YouTube account, I would appreciate you guys heading over to youtube.com/agbluesband and subscribing to my feed. I also have a lot of cool stuff up there that I don't share here on Facebook. There's some live videos. You can go back and watch some of the old Throwdown Thursdays as well as the Metal Mondays. Music videos, all the music videos that I've done are up there on my channel, some live stuff. So some things that you probably haven't seen. So if you have a chance to check out my YouTube channel, I would appreciate it greatly. And I'll get back to that before the end of everything here. Catch up with the comments. David watching from YouTube. Bill watching from YouTube. All right. Looks like we got some people on the YouTube already. Crying on Chris. What's going on, man? All right. Last riff. Name that riff. All right. Who's ready? This one, if you've been following along, you probably are going to get this one. This one is easy. However, it's a little tough. Oh, yeah. It's up to 667 now. Thank you, Liz. Thank you very much. Don't get me wrong, I did take a screenshot on my phone when I saw that I had 666 followers. Anyone know that riff? Come on now. What's up, Andrea? What's going on? Name that riff. This is the third one. So far, this is our third riff to name. I need the band and the song in the same post. You can't split them up. Gotta be in the same post. Band and song. David. Boom. David. Now, you guys that are on Facebook, this is the first time that this has happened. Like I said, I'm simulcasting to Facebook and YouTube. This is the first time a YouTube comment has come up first. David Major got it. Followed closely by Matt Shippen and Cynthia. You guys are all right there. But the first one that popped up here was David on YouTube. So who knew? This is the first time a YouTube viewer has won a riff of the week, or name that riff, or name that song. So Matt, you got right there close. I'm gonna have to say you're second, because that's what popped up on my screen here. I know you guys on the book of face can't see the YouTube comments. I get to see both of them over here. Nicely done. So let's talk about UFO for a second. Let's talk about this riff, though. Let's just talk about this riff real quick. Let me get rid of this banner here. Let's just talk about this riff. This riff is, I just got a little blurry there. My camera needs to refocus. It's a really, really cool riff. Key of E, pentatonic, but also kind of using some kind of evil notes. Really, really, really cool riff. So that is from this record right here. This is UFO I know it's a little blurry. Hopefully the camera will come back in focus. If I get closer, maybe it'll do it. UFO phenomenon. Phenomenon. This is the first record with Michael Schenker on guitar. I believe this is their third studio record total, but his first. I've been wearing this out. Pete Way passed away, the bass player from UFO, a couple weeks ago. And he was a huge influence on guys like Steve Harris from Iron Maiden, Nikki Sixx from Motley Crue. But really cool songs, all of which, except for one, were co-written by Michael Schenker. Too Young to Know, Crystal Light, Doctor Doctor, which is a very famous song of theirs. Iron Maiden opens their shows blasting the UFO song Doctor Doctor through the PA to let people know the show's about to start. Space Child, Rock Bottom, which was the riff that I just played. Oh My, Time on My Hands, Built for Comfort, which is a Willie Dixon song. That's cool, right? Blues fans, Willie Dixon song, made famous by Howlin' Wolf, Built for Comfort, great blues song. They do a pretty typical thing for a British band. They kind of straighten it out and make it kind of like this really cool rock groove. Lipstick Traces and Queen of the Deep. So there you have it, everybody. This is, I believe, from 1974. And if you don't have this, I really would recommend checking this out. It's kind of the in-between era of UFO, kind of from their beginnings to what they ended up becoming. And it's a really, really cool record. So those are the three riffs, everybody. Once again, we had Hideaway, Dennis Got Hideaway. And we had 2 Minutes to Midnight. Larry got 2 Minutes to Midnight. And David Major got UFO Rock Bottom chiming in from YouTube. So all right, thank you guys, and thank you guys for subscribing to the YouTube channel. In the event that things get sketchy on Facebook, that's where we're going to be going with these broadcasts, so appreciate that very much. Okay, back to the record, you guys. Back to the New World Blues. Here once again is the pre-order information, and this is the record cover. Comes out October 23rd. That's just under 2 months away. WhiskeyBayouRecords.com. You can pre-order. You can also pre-order at my website. We'll have an iTunes pre-order coming up shortly. So if you want to, you know, do the iTunes thing, hang in there. We'll be doing that shortly. And, you know, all the other places where you can buy music. But right now we're doing it through the record label website and my website. If you want a signed copy, you can pre-order from me. And if you would like to get it shipped to places outside the United States, or you want to buy direct from the label, which is awesome as well, go to WhiskeyBayouRecords.com. And so I got my little set list over here. What else am I going to talk about? What else am I talking about? So that's the record cover, The New World Blues, everybody. 11 original songs, 4 of which were written with Tab Benoit. I wrote with Tab. And really stoked. It's a very raw sounding record. I don't know if you've seen the little video teaser for the lead off track, Living Today, but you know, that is a very kind of more rocking track. It's a pretty blues based record. So, all right, you guys, as per some other Throwdown Thursdays, I want to show you guys, I want to share a guitar pick from my collection. I do not think I've seen this. Yeah, Built for Comfort. Let me catch up with some comments. Liz, you're on YouTube. You were on the Facebook. Shauna, thank you for tuning in on YouTube. Thank you, guys. I appreciate you guys coming in and checking this out. It's been a while. It's been like 2 months or so since I've done one of these. Brian, yeah, man. Pete Way. I'm reading the comments, everybody. If you're on YouTube, or I'm reading the Facebook comments, and then Facebook people, I'm also reading some comments from YouTube simultaneously. Cynthia, yeah, it's a great record, right? It's a killer record. So I'm going to share a guitar pick. I don't think I've shared this one. I have a few of these, and there's a little story behind this. A good friend of mine named Hector Hurtado road managed some bands back in the mid to late 90s, and he was asked to road manage a band called The Distant Cousins. And The Distant Cousins was kind of a group of guys that were in England, one of whom was close friends with Eric Clapton. And they got the tour opening up for Eric Clapton. I can't remember exactly which record it was. It was the record that had In My Father's Eyes on it. Pilgrim is the name of the record. I just pulled that out of the ether there. But my friend Hector came home with some Eric Clapton guitar picks. This one says EC 1998. I have a few Eric Clapton guitar picks because of Hector. So this one says EC 98. Now, a lot of artists will put some stuff on the back of a guitar pick that could be an inside joke with the crew, with their fans. The inside joke on this guitar pick, which I don't understand. I don't know if someone knows, but this on the back, it says fine adjustments. If you can see that kind of right there, fine adjustments, it says on the back of that guitar pick. So this is my guitar pick of the week, Eric Clapton from the 1998 Pilgrim Tour, given to me by my friend Hector. But yeah, you know, this is a hobby that I haven't been doing as much of lately, of course, but when I was going to see a lot more shows before I was playing a lot of, got busier playing shows, that was one of the things I would do. I'd collect guitar picks. I'd go to shows, try and get them. If I met one of my heroes, I'd see if they had a guitar pick. And I've, you know, traded some with some friends. It's a cool hobby. And, you know, I'll continue to share some picks with you guys. Now, I want to, I'm gonna totally surprise you guys with something right now. I don't know if you follow me on Instagram and here, and also my personal page, you'll know that I've been putting up some food pics. So you know what time it is, everybody. I'll tell you what time it is. It's time for Cooking with AG. That's right. You didn't see this one coming. I am going to just tell you real quick about how to make an inexpensive meal, and I will show you how awesome it is. This is what it looks like right here. So this, before I show you the picture, I know that you're thinking, man, why is a guitar player showing me how to make something? Because I want you guys to stoke on this. This is the Southern California version of red beans and rice, but I switched it up and I put the red beans and rice in bell peppers and did stuffed bell peppers with red beans and rice. So check this out. Oh my God, look at that, look at that. This is actually pretty easy to make, everybody. I know you're thinking this is crazy. But I'm going to show you real quick what is not a lot involved here. I've obviously had some time at home to spend cooking. My wife works. I cook. Works out well. This is not that hard to make. And Guy Fieri. I love Guy Fieri. All right, so check it out. You can obviously tell. Bell peppers, you cut them in half, okay? You kind of clean them out and make some room. I'm going to show you the ingredients right here. We have I'm a big Trader Joe's fan, but this stuff is not expensive. This is not expensive to do. It's easy to do. First, I like to start with, let me stop the share real quick here. Show you guys. This is the Trader Joe's rice. Quick cook, 15 minutes, organic brown basmati rice, 15 minutes. Gotta love that. Boom. Trader Joe's kidney beans. I'm telling you, it's easy. Okay, so this is what I did. Let me show you that picture again. Let me see if I can show you the steps. So if you're looking at that left picture, that's before everything went in the oven. You cook the rice. The rice is done. Easy. You put the beans in a scallop. Now this, I added some ground beef. You can or can't do this. Now, this is obviously traditionally a dish from the South, so this is the Southern California version. I'm sure people in the South are going, man, you're just messing this up for everybody, but this is the AG version, okay? So here's the deal. Rice is cooked. I put the beans in a skillet, get the beans cooking. I added some ground beef, add some onion. You just saute the beans, the onion together. Spices are up to you, really. You can use whatever seasoning you want. I like pepper, garlic powder, garlic salt, granulated garlic. You can cut up some garlic, throw it in the skillet. Super easy. Medium heat, just let that cook. Once it's kind of starting to happen, start mixing in the rice. You got the rice going in the pot. Boom. So you got your peppers lined up, as you can kind of see to the next picture there. If we're going clockwise from the upper left, you get to the next one there, and that's where you stuff them. You cook the beans with the rice and whatever seasoning, and if you want to put some ground beef in there, throw it in there. Then if you go down to the the, let me see if I can show you real quick a little better. If you go down to the lower left-hand corner, I just threw some cheese on there. But what I did is I actually cooked. I added the cheese last. I had the bell peppers stuffed in a baking dish. I think it was like 375, 400. You want to eyeball this stuff because I am not a professional. I'm telling you right now, I'm not a professional. Want to eyeball it, get it cooked for 30, 35 minutes, check it out. Then I put the cheese on, then threw the cheese, then put it back in there. And then you can see the final product down there in the lower right-hand side is how it came out. Cheese is melted right there on top. So I'm calling this, you know, I'm calling this my red beans and rice stuffed bell pepper recipe for you guys. So it's easy, it's quick, and more importantly, it's inexpensive. It's inexpensive. That's right. That's right. So that is Cooking with AG. That is the new one. Hey, Trader Joe's. What's up, Todd? All right, you guys. Well, I've pretty much ran down everything that I wanted to run down. You know, I'm not doing a lot of tunes today, but I am going to throw up the tip jar just for a second there if you're so inclined. Because you know what I'm going to do with that money? I'm going to go get some more red beans and rice is what's happening right there. So tip jar info, if you are so inclined to tip the band. Otherwise, you know, I would encourage you to pre-order the new record, The New World Blues. Once again, we broke down the riff. So that's the riff. We broke down that earlier. If you're just tuning in, we broke down a riff called Lies and Fear that I just played. That's from my new record called The New World Blues, produced by Tab Benoit, coming out October 23rd on Whiskey Bayou Records. And that riff was derived from three different riffs. Luther, Snake Boy Johnson, Rare Earth, and Gary Moore, all the riffs that I kind of thieved. Name that song. Congratulations to the winners. Larry, Dennis, was it Dave? David? Yeah, David's the one that got the UFO one on YouTube. Congratulations there. And there you go, you guys. Once again, this week's worthy cause. All this stuff should be in the event, so you can check it out. But this week's worthy cause is the COVID-19 Blues Musician Emergency Release Fund for blues.org. That is the Blues Foundation. And they're doing a lot of great work helping artists out in need. So what else? You guys have any other questions? I'm just going to throw some stuff up on the screen. Please, like I said, follow me on social media. And I mentioned earlier about YouTube. I saw some of you already subscribed on YouTube. How about some Jameson? It's too early for me to drink. It's only almost 2 o'clock here. What am I using that sounds beside your Les Paul? That is a good question, Brian. So, let me get rid of this banner right here. Gibson Les Paul right here. And I am plugged straight into a Hughes & Kettner TubeMeister 36 head over here. And a just a kind of a generic speaker cabinet. It's got a Celestion Vintage 30 in it. And that's it. I got an EP booster down here on my pedal board. And I have my little loop station going on down here that I have my loop going on with. So that's the tone there. Yeah, everyone digging the stuffed bells, man. All right. Well, it's nice to see some of you guys on YouTube. Appreciate that. Like I said, we are going to be streaming to YouTube, and I need to get the followers up on my YouTube channel. Got to get to 1,000. We were at 666 earlier today, and I believe we're at 667, 668 right now. So thank you guys for doing that. Just in the event that Facebook gets weird and we can't continue to party here on Facebook, we're going to be moving the party to YouTube. But in order to keep the party rolling on YouTube, I need 1,000 subscribers. So would appreciate you guys if you have a YouTube account. Log in and give me a subscribe. Hit subscribe. A lot of cool content there. That's where we put our music videos, live stuff. There's some older episodes of Throwdown Thursdays and Metal Mondays. that you can check out on there, and I'm going to be uploading some other stuff there as well. You can also go there and check out our little trailer video to the song that is opening the record. It's called Living Today. It's the first song on the new album. So one more song. Well, I'll do Living Today for you guys. I'll do a little bit of Living Today. Hey, thanks, David. Really appreciate that, man. You know, you guys, this is all pretty grassroots, and appreciate all you guys sharing. You know, that's what we need. We need us musicians that are home making music. We need you guys sharing the videos, sharing the feeds, sharing the announcements. We really appreciate all that. And like I said, if you're on the YouTube... Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Brian. All right, I'll do a song. I wasn't going to do a song, but I'll do a song. Here's the pre-order info one more time if you want to pre-order the record. And there's a little of that there if you want to tip the band. All right, I'm going to do a little bit of Living Today for you guys. This is the first song on the record. And it's a song that I wrote just about living today. Well, I know you can feel it, but I can feel it too. Well, I know you can feel it, and nothing wrong with you. The whole world's gone crazy, the whole world's gone mad. Everybody feel uneasy, everyone feeling sad. Remember to let your love shine through. Remember to let your love shine through. Well, I know you can see it. Well, I can see it too. Well, I know you can see it. Everyone's got the blues. The whole world's gone crazy. The whole world's gone mad. Everybody feels uneasy. Everyone feeling sad. Remember to let your love shine through. Remember to let your love shine through. It ain't easy living today, but our love will find a way. Don't look back at the end of the day. Yeah, my love will find a way. Yeah, yeah. We'll be right back. live on the Facebook. Catch up with some comments. All right. Well, thank you, guys. Thank you guys for subscribing to the YouTube channel. Please appreciate that. Tell your friends. Tell your friends. I also do an email list. I shoot out emails. I've been doing that for years, actually. If you want to go to, yeah, there it is, myname.com. Get on the email list. I've got some stuff that I send out to the email list. You know, Facebook isn't everything. Love it. You know, we do post a lot here, but there's also things in the email blasts that are a little different. Some different content there, as well as the YouTube channel, as well as Instagram and Twitter. Trying, you know, a lot of similar things that I share, but try and kind of post different things, different places sometimes. So, Chris, thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you, Kostya. Thank you, Rich. What's up? What's up, everybody? All right. Good to see everybody. Well, we'll do this again soon. I will let you know when. Probably do it in a couple of weeks. We'll do another one of these. Please stay tuned. And once again, let me just show you the album artwork. I'm so excited about it. I am so excited about it, everybody. I really am. New World Blues coming at you. Coming at you. October 23rd is the release date, everybody. So pre-order a copy today. And there you go. That's my spiel. Hope you guys had a good time. And we'll do some more again. Thank you, Cynthia. Corey, right on. Thank you. We'll do it again, Larry, Pam. Scrolling through some comments. All right, you guys. Well, have a good rest of your day. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to get out of here. And we'll do it again. So stay tuned, and we will join up and play some more music. Hey, Michael. Thank you, brother man. Good to see you. Hope you're doing well out there in Europe, wherever you are now. I think you were in Italy recently, right? Craig, thank you, man, from Germany. Thank you very much. Got some friends from all over the world tuning in. So awesome. Well, I'll go back through the comments, you guys. If you have any other questions, throw them in there or comment on the post, and I'll go through and we'll do it again. All right. So be safe out there, everybody. Take care of each other. Be good humans. And thank you for joining in on this is the lucky 13 episode of Throwdown Thursdays. Can't believe this is the 13th one. We haven't done one in a couple months. So you guys be safe, okay? Take care.